And Pat Niagara was standing outside of the Thorold Secondary School on the first day of school back. We're here to protest that schools are charging a student fee, which is being played up like it's mandatory when in fact it's voluntary. And about the problem of Ontario schools denying kids access into their schools in their own communities.
I'm not here to tell everybody don't pay your fee, you know, even though it is voluntary and not mandatory, but I believe the schools should word it differently and allow the parents to make the choice. It's that simple. They make you want to come into the school, you go to pick up your timetable, or do you have your fee? No, I don't. Well, we can't give you a timetable. That is incorrect. They can so give you a timetable, and the school board and the schools need to word it so that the parents understand that these fees are voluntary.
Where can that information be found?
On the Ministry of Education's website. You put in the search bar, secondary school fees, and it'll come up, and you type on it in, and it's a download, and you can print it off for your own future reference.
No, I will not allow you to deal with a minor.
Actually, this is it here, where it clearly states every student has the right to attend school where they are a qualified pupil without the payment of a fee. There should be no fees charged for school day programs.
And I've told you on the megaphone, we will be here every single day.
Scroll down if you happen to be on the website. You go to student activity fees. Those are the fees they generally charge at the beginning of the year.
Well, then Brett will not be
there. It states right there that the student activity fees are voluntary amounts. So if you have an inability to pay for whatever reason, you don't need to pay. And it's none of their business what your financial situation is.
And you know what? And I'm going to educate
Thank you.
Every student.
You're welcome.
Did it rain hard on you guys?
A little bit.
It's done for now, I think.
You're going to be famous. Going on YouTube, boys. He was a goof off. He got suspended a couple of times, however. How many other kids are suspended on a regular basis from this school? Right? One credit. It's all he needs to graduate. And he doesn't even care if he gets to go to the ceremony. Just give me my diploma, I'll get out of your hair.
I haven't gotten any graduation.
I got suspended in elementary.
I was there for one time.
I went to the prostitute's room.
can see behind us, we got a number of kids from the Thorold Secondary School that have signed the Ombudsman Petition and seem to want to hang out with Ken at the court watch.
It's for Ombudsman Oversight of the School Boards.
Students of Thorold Secondary School, are you aware that your principal, Miss Miller, has been robbing you blind by charging you fees for registration, which you do not have to pay under the Ministry of Education guidelines? I know she's standing by the door and she can hear it. The fee that they charge you for your timetable, you do not have to pay. It is not mandatory, it is voluntary, and she knows it. If they ask you for a fee, you can refer them back to the Ministry of Education website where it clearly states it is not mandatory and you do not have to pay it, and they cannot charge you a fee to be registered at the school to attend regular classes. Miss Miller is denying a student his final credit to graduate, and under the law, he must be in school until he's 18 years of age or graduates. He has done neither. He's only 17 and has not graduated, and Miss Miller refuses to allow him access to that school. The school was barely saved from closure due to low enrollment numbers. Miss Miller is denying students from this own residence area that's qualified for this school from attending, simply because she does not like the student's parent, and she refuses to deal with him. The media has been out here twice already today, and we will be here each and every day educating your students on the rights that you have, that you do not have to pay these fees until Miss Miller realizes what she is doing is wrong. If she's willing to come over and talk to us, I am the parent of the student she's denying access to the school, and I'm more than willing to work with her and talk with her. But she refuses to work with us. She wants to deal with the child himself, who is a minor, and she does not have that authority. He has the right to a parent present. She's more than welcome to come over here and talk with us. We're going to be here every day until she does.
You've broken absolutely
zero
law.
You went up St. David's Road, Chris, parking there.
That's right. That's another cop.
Oh, shit's going down. Everybody looking.
Get the camera going, Pat. Pat, turn the camera on.
It's rolling.
Is that another copter?
Yep.
Yeah. He's slowing down.
I don't care. We're done.
Chris, get us arrested. I think me and him are going to kill you.
Yeah, it's the resource.
Can't park there.
Okay, I'll
do
a little bit.
No,
I'll do a little bit. I'll let you know why.
Hello.
How are you?
Good. Chris?
Yeah.
Long time no see.
Been what? 5 weeks?
Yeah.
Yeah, about that.
I got my trial in January.
What's that, buddy?
Trial in January.
Yes, Miller called him.
We got a call. Actually, it was the teacher going into the principal for taking the work slow.
And it was on lunch hour.
Well, regardless, Ray called from.
Oh, you push Reaper!
During lunch hour. We can do it during lunch hour, but I spoke with Sergeant McAllister.
I have my hand behind my back.
During the last time, because we were nice to because we didn't want to disrupt the class time, because they do have the right to an education.
Right.
However, on the lunch hour, while they're coming out, we would use the megaphone to interrupt people. And Sergeant McAllister said, as long as you're keeping it peaceful and not breaking any laws, there's nothing we can do. I did speak to the staff sergeant this morning to give him a heads up that we were going to be and what we were going to do. I even informed him we usually use the blowhorn. However, during the class times, I just told him, I said, you have our word, we would not use the blowhorn during the times of the class being accepted. Because I don't want to focus on because that would be a distraction for us. On lunch hour, it's a different story because they're on their own lunch time, they're out here educating. And that's exactly what it is. So the classes started back up. And we got it all recorded on camera.
Well, that's fine.
I said,
look at you go.
You're a
professional.
You've dealt with us before. You.
The other issue. Yeah.
No criticisms of that whatsoever, right?
That's why we're here. She won't let him in.
Oh, you, I am all back. I'm already there. I'm lost credit.
And that's why we're here.
Yeah.
Tried to.
Miller wants to be with me alone.
Miller wants to meet with him alone, and he's a minor. And I said, no, you are not meeting with my stepson alone. He's a minor, and you have to deal with him. And she flatly refused. She said, no, Brett will meet with me alone, or he's not coming to the school. I said, well, that's not happening. So I've contacted the superintendent of the school, and I told him, if she wants to meet him, she doesn't want me in the building of the school, that's fine. We can meet at the school board office as a compromise. But he is not meeting with her alone, because she cannot trust him. And as a parent, I have the right to refuse to allow my minor child to meet privately with anybody. And we knew she was going to call right after lunch because we educated a few students on the rights that they didn't have to pay the activity fees that they're charging and register for school.
I'm not here to debate board politics with you, right?
She's just upset because she doesn't
care. Again, speak the way she feels, right?
During class time, so we made it a point we would not use it. I gave my word to the staff sergeant. I said flat out, we will not use it during class time. I always keep my word. We may have a problem with Ms. Miller who's sitting there watching us right now, but you know what? I'm keeping that problem between me and the school management. I'm not going to take care of it. Students have a right to get an education, and I'm not going to interrupt that problem.
I know my rights. I'm just concerned now that my daughter is...
She's more upset with the fact the media's been here twice, publishing a story, and publicly embarrassing her.
Right. I have harmed my daughter.
And the fact that we've said we're going to be here each and every single day, from 9 a.m. until noon, including back. He will not lose his business call tomorrow. No explanation for why he's not being allowed to school his final credit. Other than the fact that she said, we discussed this in June, I told you you're not coming back tomorrow. She profiled him because of the fact she expelled his aunt at Ridgeway. She expelled his uncle at Ridgeway, along with her friend. And she also expelled his uncle here and his older brother Michael.
And the buzzy of it.
No, exactly. I do, unfortunately. The biggest problem is she don't like me. She don't like the fact that last year he was having problems, so I sent him to school and he put reporting devices.
We're good. We can get that.
Deal with him. Get reported. See if you report him. She's right to do so. Well, she got offended by it and said, no, you can't do that. You need our permission. I said, perhaps you need to go to law school. Take a full look at section 183.1, subsection A of the criminal code, where as it states, it's a one-party consent. As long as one party is aware of the reporting and consents to it, it is legal. If he's a part of the conversation, he can legally be a consenting party. You don't like it? Get yourself elected to the legislature and change the law. Until then, there's nothing you can do about it. Exactly.
183.1A.
183 is a broad section.
Yeah.
You get into all the different subsections and sub-subsections to get the specific nature of them, right?
Yes, because I was just telling him I've armed my daughter with her reporter today at school in case she gets called to the office.
Oh, I already went to her.
So, it was advised by me to turn the reporter on when she enters the office. I just want my daughter not to be affected, have her education affected, because I'm out here promoting accountability.
Right.
You know what I mean? She's in there.
She is hated by almost every parent in the
I'm not gonna. It's all right.
Yeah, we dealt with it many times.
Another 20 minutes after you leave, just so that they understand that you didn't.
The hydro people show up and tell you to leave.
That's different, right?
Then we'll just park in front of the arena and stand on the sidewalk.
We made sure there was no trespass.
Yep. At 11:05. After lunch is over, then you go back to class.
Forty-five.
Yeah, lunch is over now. 20 after 12, lunch is over. No, you guys got to do your job.
Behind you.
We have a brochure that we give to the police of what we do, so you can take it with you.
Oh, this is our new one.
Alright, so we gotta go over and talk to her now, so. Got it?
Okay.
Stay dry.
Unfortunately for her, we're gonna be here every day until he's back in.
Without the megaphone.
Except for lunch hour. Once no one realizes the cops could not force us to stop using the megaphone during the lunch hour, I could not.
Don't you gotta care?
I'm Ellie.